previously on Mad Men.
I did everything right, and I'm still getting it from you.
We're in the running. I mean, actually, this time. For Jaguar.
Since I was a little girl, it's all I ever dreamed about.
I don't want to keep you from your dream. I have a spectacular new side dish in the city.
Aren't you worried you're going to get caught?
I got an apartment. When we land Jaguar, the world will know we've arrived.
Jaguar, the mistress who will do things your wife won't.
What'd I say before? The client doesn't want to hear the word mistress. Salesman can use it, but the campaign can't.
Jaguar, you'll love it when you're in it.
Are we just spitting up lines now?
You know what? Stick break.
Where are you going? Well, it's unclear about the fact that he's taking a break, and we're not.
Secret laxative.
I told you you were in charge of all ongoing business till Jaguar's done. Just handle it.
Done. How's the prospect doing? Is it lunchtime?
Jesus, is it?
Mr. Sterling bought lobster from the Palm. Doesn't that sound good?
So I don't know what the Jaguar executives will say, but I got dealerships in Montclair, Englewood, Morristown, Paramus, and Rutherford, and I carry three other foreign cars. So, frankly, creative has to be pretty spectacular. But Jaguar's just another word on the sign.
Well, then we have nothing to worry about.
The dealership on the ground floor of the corporate offices on Madison has done very well just having that XKE in the entrance. You have to be excited about this car.
Oh, it's a red-hot number. I'm excited about that. But I'm a hard man to please. I always feel like someone should go the extra mile.
We're open to anything your heart desires.
Well, the other day when we were all touring your offices, our guide was a dynamite redhead.
Joan Harris.
Built like a B-52.
Well, we know who you're talking about.
Well, I sure would like the opportunity to get to know her better.
Well, a lot of guys would, but, you know, she's...
She's a very interesting girl.
She's one of these free spirits, you know, open to ideas.
So you like redheads? I think I know some.
I like that redhead. And I think she and I would both welcome the opportunity to spend a night together.
Well, you could ask her out. It wouldn't be a conflict.
No. I'm kind of shy. All I'm saying is, if it happens, it would make me happy. If it doesn't, well, no guarantees in life, right? Get another round. I'll get it.
Absolutely not. Was that what I think it was?
Yes, it was.
Why didn't you just let me tell him she was married?
Because so is he. And he already knows that.
Well, we wanted to be in the car business.
You waited up?
No. I mean, yes. I'm going in to read tomorrow for a really good part.
An audition? Why didn't you call?
Oh, honestly, because I had to go to 10th Avenue to get the script, and then I went and talked to Fanny, you know, who teaches my auditioning class.
You're very good at auditions.
As good as the girls who get parts. You know what? Let's talk about your day.
Well, I was going to watch Carson and cry myself to sleep.
It'll come to you. It always does.
Unless it comes to you.
Do you really want help, or you want to yell at me?
I don't know yet.
What's the strategy?
The Jaguar is beautiful, but unreliable. It comes with a toolkit the size of a typewriter. You basically have to own another car to go places. So we're saying it's your gorgeous mistress.
So a wife is like a Buick in the garage.
We're trying to make a weakness into a strength. We're selling to men.
No, I got it. Doesn't being a mistress make the car immoral?
The word mistress won't be in the ad.
I don't know. It sounds great. I need to learn some of this.
There goes the act. One shot, and there goes the tambourine.
You're here early. What can I do for you?
Nothing.
Nothing. It's just I got some bad news last night, and I was hoping you'd help me deliver it.
What happened?
Well, we were having dinner with Herb Rennett. I think you met him the other day from Jaguar. Handsome guy?
I don't remember any of them.
Well, I don't know what to do. He basically pledged he wasn't going to back us.
Why not?
It turns out he wanted something we're not prepared to give. Something very unorthodox.
Good morning.
Yes,
I'm here. I'm going to get Danish.
What does he want?
I feel like I shouldn't even bring this up. In fact, I don't know how to bring this up, but we're going to lose Jaguar unless an arrangement is made, and it involves you and, well, Herb.
How did that come up?
He said he was crazy about you, and then he just asked. And then I thought we were past it, but right before we put him in a cab, he said it again. And it was quite conditional. A night with you or no vote.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
Anyway, if you can think of some way to break the news to the company that we're out of this, I'd really appreciate it.
You're unbelievable. I'm married. How would you feel if someone asked Trudy?
I didn't bring this up. He did. If you're not interested in the idea at all, I appreciate... It's just... It seems to me that there's something that could be worth the sacrifice. We're talking about a night in your life. We've all had nights in our lives where we've made mistakes for free.
You're talking about prostitution.
I'm talking about business at a very high level. Do you consider Cleopatra a prostitute?
Where do you get this stuff?
She was a queen. What would it take to make you a queen?
I don't think you could afford it.
This was an act of desperation. I hope I haven't insulted you. That's all that matters to me.
I understand.
Scarlett, we're ready. Now, we can't get Ginsburg out for the call, so we want you to pretend you're his junior. Partner?
Supervisor.
I have Mr. Rick Swanson from Chevalier Blanc Cologne on speaker.
Hi, Rick. It's Kenny. I'm here on a speaker with Harry Crane and Peggy Olson, Mr. Ginsburg's supervisor, and we want to know why you want to pull the ad.
Hello, everyone.
Hi, Rick.
Hello.
We're very happy with the work, but sales have leveled off since the holidays.
It's Harry, and you know, Valentine's Day is coming up. A girl can't get a guy flowers.
Why would a woman buy a man anything for Valentine's Day?
Rick, it's Peggy. I think you're right. The target of a hard day's night was men, but we can easily change that.
How do you do that? Hello?
What if it's our leather jacket hero running down the street being chased by screaming girls, and instead of jumping into a bar, he comes upon Lady Godiva on a horse, as naked as we are allowed to make her. And he stops short, but she leans down and picks him up and puts him on the horse and rides away with him.
What's the tagline?
It's something about how, you know, the right woman loves Chevalier Blanc.
So it's exactly the same, except for the ending.
And maybe Paris instead of London?
La la, a French song.
Close the door, please. Herb Rennett has demanded to spend a night with Joan. And I don't mean dinner and dancing.
He just came right out and said that?
Who is he?
He's the head of the Dealers Association, and I hope you told him to take a long walk.
There's three votes. We only need two.
I thought about that, but all he has to do is say he can't sell cars with our campaign, and neither marketing nor the factory will fight him.
So?
So I brought up the subject with Joan.
You what?
Now, relax. She seemed more amused than shocked, and it's my opinion if we brought her the right amount.
So you thought you'd have us in here for coffee and talk about this?
What's the problem if she's amenable?
She said she'd do it?
She said we couldn't afford it.
She has a husband in Vietnam and a baby at home. And the work will be good enough to win on its own.
Plus, it's not a guarantee.
No, it's not. It's a guarantee we won't get it if we don't.
You have some nerve to even ask her.
That's right. And you should be thanking me, because we've come too far and are too close to turning this place into what it should be. Now we're going to walk away? Over what?
He's one guy, and we can win it without him. End of discussion.
Speaking of one guy, how does everyone else feel? I'd love to approach her with, say, a 10% finder's fee on the first year's commission. That's $50,000, a flattering amount which begs no negotiation.
I'm not going to stand in the way, but I'm not paying for it.
Not even with our Christmas bonuses?
Maybe Jaguar wasn't meant to be, hmm? I say we take our bonuses and move on. This is a car. You cannot put a dollar figure on its significance.
Extend our credit line. Say it's for Jaguar.
Well, why don't I
look into it to see what we can afford, so you may approach her in the morning with something definitive.
So, we're 75% of this company. There's no need to create conspiracy by having a vote, is there?
Don't fool yourself. This is some very dirty business.
Let her know she can still say no.
You know what? We're not doing this mistress thing. It's vulgar. We're going back to racing heritage.
Why?
People think writers horse around because they're coming up with ideas, but actually it's because they're horsing around. Now knock off the grab ass and give me some lines, and don't try to reuse these. They do not apply.
Hey, Skipper, you got 5 seconds?
5 seconds is not enough time to sit down.
Good news. Chevalier Blanc wants to do a pull out.
Great.
I think it was incredible. She came up with this Lady Godiva bit on the spot.
But in the end, we're doing the same ad as before, but in Paris. The guy has a beret.
Spit it out. Ginsburg should be free by then. He has to get him out of here.
Ginsburg? I thought of this.
It's his account.
So I guess I'm not in charge of everything.
Jesus. Peggy, you know what? You want to go to Paris? Here. Go to Paris.
Not crying.
I didn't think that.
What, we're all suddenly interested in each other's lives?
I know for a fact that Jaguar's not going to happen. And he probably does, too.
I don't care.
I'll get you to Paris. And if I don't, we'll both get out of here.
You and your stupid pact. Save the fiction for your stories. What can I do for you?
Signing Jaguar would be disastrous for the financial health of this company.
You have to stop being afraid. It would be a defining moment for our business.
I don't want it that badly.
All right, get out.
It bears discussion.
I don't know what you're talking about. Now get out.
Well, I'm sorry that there was a discussion. But when a company is planning on spending $50,000, there needs to be a discussion.
You're all in there talking about it?
Well, why does it matter if you've no intention of action?
I don't want them to know I was asked. Roger Sterling participated in this discussion?
Yes. He's a partner.
If you're against it, why'd you tell me that number? Sounds like a joke.
Because that may be enough money to turn your head. And I wanted a chance to discourage you.
It is a lot of money, Lane. It's 4 times what I make in a year. I suppose you wouldn't even be tempted.
Well, if I were, I would try to avoid the mistake that I've made my entire life. Every time someone's asked me what I wanted, I've never told them the truth.
And what would you want?
3 years ago, when I was essential to the future of this firm, I settled for much less than I needed. The cash would only cripple the company and would do very little to change your future. But a partnership yielding a 5% stake in the company itself could take care of a woman and a child for a lifetime.
Here, I thought you were trying to stop this because you have feelings for me.
That's why I'm looking out for your interests over the company's.
Good night, nobody. Good night, Mosh. And good night to the old lady, whispering hush.
Hey.
How's it going?
You want to help us out? Throw some taglines at the wall?
Oh, how about Jaguar? It's your problem, not mine. May I speak with you?
So that's Megan.
Be careful what you say. We're best friends.
So you're wearing your audition dress. What are you hoping I can do for you?
You noticed.
I have only bad associations with letting you leave the house in that.
There's probably 20 girls, and Julia's coming with me. Plus, he's a fairy.
So whatever this is, it's not for me.
I want to walk in it with confidence.
I could be in a bikini and you could paint my body with spots.
Jaguar, try and tame it.
Don't try and tame it.
You're kidding, kitty.
She just comes and goes as she pleases, huh?
Ginsburg?
Yeah, I got it.
You can unplug that if you want.
Aren't I interrupting your routine without me?
Don't be cranky.
I was in a great mood when I left work. Now I'm just exhausted.
So let's go to bed.
If and when we get Jaguar, I'm going to need an apartment in the city.
Absolutely not.
It's an epic poem for me to get home. And you're dressed for bed at dinner.
Peter, let's stop playing games.
What are you talking about?
I'm tired of competing. Your love affair with Manhattan is over.
Well, how can you stand living out here in this cemetery? There's nothing to do. There's no good night noises anywhere.
Because I want to raise my child in the fresh air. And we should have another on the way. I mean, it was a miracle the first time, and we're not even trying.
I'm using all my energy putting my foot down.
Humiliating us or showing respect.
Well, that's all right when you're prepared.
It's 8. Where were you?
What's that smell?
The refrigerator's on the fritz. I had to take everything out.
Did you call someone?
His wife won't let him come here anymore.
I don't want to talk about that. We can afford to have someone else fix the refrigerator, for God's sake.
Why won't anyone believe me? Apollo and I are just friends. You know what? Just hire someone. Get a colored girl in here. They're used to being bossed around.
Do whatever you want.
What are you doing? Drying up inside? Because what, Greg? I hate him.
I don't want you talking that way around Kevin.
He's a baby. He doesn't know that we all wish his father was dead.
Please stop.
Have you been drinking?
Yes.
Sit down.
Little Murders called. Four of us got callbacks. I'm supposed to go meet the playwright tomorrow.
That's fantastic. That's a big deal.
I know. You have to promise you'll come visit every weekend.
You're going to Broadway, not jail.
No, rehearsal starts in Boston in 10 days. Oh, forget it. I'm getting ahead of myself.
Boston?
Yeah, I think there's 8 weeks of rehearsals plus previews.
So you're just going to leave for 3 months?
If they want me.
Well, forget it.
What do you think this is? You think I'm going to be a singing waitress? Maybe put on a show in the laundry room?
I have to go to work.
You never thought about it because you didn't expect me to make it. This is the way it works. Now you know.
Just keep doing whatever the hell you want.
Please, come in. You didn't have to make an appointment, you know?
Yes, I did. Tell them I want a partnership, not silent, comprising 5% of the business.
Well,
there's no negotiation.
Okay.
I want documents by the end of the day.
I don't know if that's possible.
Well, I'm not guaranteeing results.
I don't think he'll have trouble performing. He's quite ardent.
I meant winning the business.
Yes, of course. So, I have instructions, but I don't know how this works in a practical sense.
The presentation's tomorrow, isn't it?
So, I just call him and have him call you?
Probably not.
Well, how do I...
figure something out. Do I have to do all of it? Which one is he?
He's not bad.
He's doing this.
I know I'm not a manager, but it's very hard to get things done with you in another room.
Well, I obviously have the opposite feeling.
Permission to speak freely?
What?
I know you forbid us from thinking about the mistress, but I kept imagining the asshole who's going to want this car now. He's probably already got a lot of beautiful things.
Or maybe he thinks the car will help him get them.
So I can go on? And one way or another, what he has isn't enough. So no matter what, the first idea has got to be, finally, like you're getting what you wanted. The copy is still describing the car as another woman, but a woman you can't have because they have all the qualities of a Jaguar. Good looking, expensive, fast, and frankly, not practical.
I've always been fine with all that, but what's the line?
Jaguar, at last, something beautiful you can truly own.
We threw the money in your face?
I don't even want to talk about it. I've never had more responsibility. I'm on everything but Jaguar.
I worked on Plymouth and NW Air. Car guys are a bunch of creeps.
They're all a bunch of creeps.
Could I get some more coffee? Yeah, I can never tell, Ballerina, if you're ambitious or you just like to complain.
Why can't I be both?
Well, if this was about work and not feelings, you'd make a move.
You're right. I could take a couple of meetings and get an offer and throw that in Don's face.
Or you can do what everybody else does. Have a bunch of meetings, pick a place, and leave.
Don't think I haven't thought about it.
Well, you get to find out if you could shine elsewhere. And I know you can. And you'd let him know that you're not some secretary from Brooklyn who's dying to help out.
I don't know if I can do that.
Sure you could. You could hire a headhunter. Or you could buy a friend a piece of pie. Of course, if you do move, you can't complain if I gave Draper a call on my own behalf.
What if Don finds out you helped me?
Don's a big boy. If he was having this conversation with you and he wasn't the subject of it, he'd tell you to leave in a second.
I've seen the campaign, and it's something I couldn't have imagined, yet exactly what I expected.
Thank you.
And I want you to present in the fullest confidence.
I think it's a winner.
Well, all I wanted to say was we've removed all other impediments. But you do know, no matter what else goes on, it's the creative that's going to win this.
Close the door.
It was 4-0. You abstained in absentia. The conversation doesn't end just because you leave the room.
What did you promise her?
A 5% stake as a voting partner.
Dawn, could you buzz Mrs. Harris?
She's not here.
Actually, Dawn, could you get my things?
Yes. You should be well rested.
I don't want it like this.
It was her idea.
Hello.
Hello. I'm Don Draper. I work with Joan. Is she in?
Yes, of course. Please come in. She'll be right with you. I should take your coat.
I won't be long.
Well, I will leave you two alone.
I'm really sorry to bother you if this is a bad time.
Well, I was just stepping into the shower, but how can I help you?
I wanted to tell you it's not worth it. And if we don't get Jaguar, so what? Who wants to be in business with people like that?
I was told everyone was on board.
I said no, and they voted when I left the room.
You're a good one, aren't you?
So you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, I do. I'm all right. And thank you.
So you have a nice night, and I'm gonna go prepare. Say goodnight to your friend.
Good luck tomorrow.
You must get tired of hearing what a beautiful thing this car is. But I've met a lot of beautiful women in my life. And despite their protestations, they never tire of hearing it. But when deep beauty is encountered, it arouses deep emotions. Because it creates a desire. Because it is, by nature, unattainable.
You look radiant, Joan. May I call you Joan? I'm Herb, by the way.
Well, I should hope so.
We're taught to think that function is all that matters. But we have a natural longing for this other thing.
Well, I got you a little something. I thought a woman with your complexion would look good in Emerald.
When I was driving the E-Type, I passed a 10-year-old boy in the back window of a station wagon, and I watched his eyes follow. He'd just seen something he would want for the rest of his life.
I feel like a sultan of Arabia, and my tent is graced with Helen of Troy.
Those are two different stories.
He'd just seen that unattainable object speed by just out of reach. Because they do that, don't they? Beautiful things.
Now, I don't know how much longer I can restrain myself. Let me see him.
Then I thought about a man of some means reading Playboy or Esquire, flipping past the flesh to the shiny painted curves of this car. There's no effort to stop his eye. The difference is, he can have a Jaguar.
Well, thank you for a wonderful time. You're a hell of a gal.
Oh, this car. This thing, gentlemen. What price would we pay? What behavior would we forgive? If they weren't pretty, if they weren't temperamental, if they weren't beyond our reach and a little out of our control, would we love them like we do? Jaguar. At last, something beautiful you can truly own.
What? Mr. Draper's here to see you.
Why'd you tell him I was here? He's your boss. You should see him.
Well, I will leave you two alone.
I'm really sorry to bother you if this is a bad time.
Well, I was just stepping into the shower, but how can I help you?
I wanted to tell you it's not worth it. And if we don't get Jaguar, so what? Who wants to be in business with people like that?
How'd it go?
We'll see. It was one of his good ones. Can I have a drink?
Maybe later.
Where are you from?
New York.
Turn around, please. Could you step forward, sweetheart, and turn around, please?
You know, I would have taken you anywhere.
Well, no one comes in here. The food's too bad.
We're not actually going to eat here, are we?
I'm not hungry.
Freddie Rumsen says you are. And so does Tom Vogel. You know we have clear so. In fact, he sung your praises while he was yelling at me that the work wasn't as good anymore.
That was my first account.
Everybody else is going to want to know if you're married or planning on having a baby. And then they're going to want to know how much you want to be paid. But all I want to know is, you must have heard some pretty terrible things about me from Don Draper's mouth. But why would you want to play for the other team?
It's not a game. It's my career.
Look, I need a writer. They don't have to be like me, but... Do you know anything about Ralph Waldo Emerson?
From school.
He said that you have to be a transparent eyeball. What he meant was, you have to take in the world and pass it through you. I am tired of people who treat this like math. I looked at your book, and I saw somebody who was writing like every product was for them. No cliches, no homilies, no formula.
Well, I had a lot of help.
Everybody does. So I lied to you. What do you want to get paid? Freddie tell you to do this? You already know you want to go. You know how much you'll do it for. And you didn't make me wait. I'm going to do you the same favor.
Oh.
If this is your last meeting.
I think I need a chocolate shake.
First day of work ends with you and me at La Caravelle.
You're here.
I'm here.
How'd it go?
How did yours go?
We're waiting to hear.
I bet you were great.
I bet you were too.
The difference is, I want you to get it.
Stop it.
Well, you get to disappear for work whenever you want. And if I have to choose between you and that, I'll choose you. But I'll hate you for it.
You know I don't want you to fail.
Good. Because I'm not going to.
Don't run away like that.
Olson wants to see you.
Peggy! Come on in!
Darcy's out.
Says who? Arthur's girl told me on the QT. She said he was in his office crying.
Jaguar's calling the president of every agency. The answer just got a big no thanks.
Darcy's out too.
Get the partners in my office and wait for further instructions.
Roger Sterling's office.
I want all the partners here.
We can't leave them on hold. Where's Pete? Just answer it.
Hello, Hugh, how are you this morning? Well, I'm glad to hear that. We like him too. Well, that is terrific news.
Bravo! Spectacular.
Great. We'll be over this afternoon to kiss the bride. He said it wasn't even close.
Well, congratulations, everyone.
We gotta get champagne.
I promise you they're opening it right now.
Before everybody's too drunk, I need a list of names. I promised them we'd staff up immediately, and we're going over there today.
Can't we wait to see what the scope of the campaign will be? Is this about the bonuses again? There are no bonuses this year. Now, next year.
John, shall we address the men?
Talk to me.
Are you busy?
I'm not in the mood.
You really have no idea when things are good, do you? I swear, I don't really need to talk right now.
Drink with me.
I have to talk about something kind of serious.
I can't put a girl on Jaguar. For these car guys, I just can't. But you know...
It's not that.
Is this about Joan being my partner?
What?
The circumstances... She's been with us 13 years.
I want you to know that the day you saw something in me, my whole life changed. And since then, it's been my privilege to not only be at your side, but to be treated like a protege. and for you to be my mentor and my champion.
But
I think I've reached a point where it's time for me to have a new experience.
Really?
I'm giving my notice. I've accepted another offer.
Are you done?
I'm giving the customary 2 weeks. My last day will be the third. And don't think...
It's been crazy around here, and I know I've been taking you for granted, and frankly, I'm impressed. You finally picked the right moment to ask for a raise.
It's time for me to move on.
Come on.
I'm serious.
You're serious?
It wasn't easy.
Oh, I'm sure it wasn't. Well, good for you. Where are you going?
Cutler, Gleason, and Shaw.
Perfect. Okay. Well, let's pretend I'm not responsible for every single good thing that's ever happened to you. And you tell me the number, or make one up, and I'll beat it.
There's no number.
There's no number? How long do you want to play this out?
I'm sorry, but... You know this is what you would do.
You don't need to wait until the third. I've got a room full of freelancers out there. I'll get by.
I understand.
Episode of AMC's Mad Men.
I don't like what we're doing.
So you're drinking with a purpose?
I'm sure there are others more deserving.
Were you celebrating with Don?
Should we be having this conversation on the phone?
You know, you can't keep being the good little boy while the adults run this business.
We're going to celebrate.
You can't tell anyone.
Only 2 episodes left this season.